Hey guys, a very good evening to all my crypto believers. So have you all been curious about what's happening in the market? Don't you worry, the CoinMonks got you covered. Okay, so before starting with the updates, let's quickly quote today's headlines. India reportedly postpones to test digital rupee in Q1 in 2023 amid banning private cryptos. Clinton regulate crypto to stop manipulation by Russia and China. Japan's major banks join consortium of private firms to launch yen-based digital currency. eToro cites regulatory concerns as it plans to delist Cardano and Tron for US users. Firstly, the Indian government has postponed the trial date of testing digital rupee until Q1 of 2023, the digital form of central bank digital currency, local media outlets reported. Well, I was quite excited about their stand. Let's see what they bring up. Looks like TikTok and PUBG weren't the only things that Indian government wanted to ban. Anyways, let's have a look at what's getting cooked. At the forthcoming winter conference of parliament, the administration is expected to introduce a measure banning private cryptocurrency. The Indian parliament will vote on the encryption and supervision of the Official Digital Currency Act 2021, chosen by the country's central bank to encourage the formation of the central bank digital currency, according to a published report from the Lok Sabha. India has previously stated that it will begin testing the electronic rupee by the end of 2021. Local media, however, indicated that the administration was unable to do the soft launch in December, delaying the test by nearly a year, according to online publication CoinGeek. India has recently announced plans to prohibit all private cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin and Ethereum from fostering the development of blockchain technology. According to the announcement, in addition, the bill wants to outlaw all private cryptocurrencies in India. It does, however, allow for some exceptions in order to promote cryptocurrencies' underlying technology and applications. According to Mikhail Morch, Executive Director and Risk Management at ARK36, a crypto digital assets hedge fund, at this time the scope of the proposed legislation's ban does not appear to be clear. While the bill's summary claims that the bill's goal is to ban all non-government cryptocurrencies, it also mentions some exceptions. Potential use of cryptocurrencies for illicit activities or manipulative investment schemes may be some of the primary concerns here, Morch continued, citing Prime Minister Modi's tweet from a few days ago. Based on the data from the World Bank, the world's fifth largest economy continues to be cautious by handling the launch of CBDC to avoid any catastrophic moves to its economy. So moving ahead with our next update, the former Secretary of State warns that if left unregulated, cryptocurrency markets and social media platforms could destabilize the US dollar as the reserve currency. Our next update is about manipulation. Just like you were manipulated by your parents that life would be easy after high school. Anyways, let's have a look at our headline. Former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton has stated that cryptocurrency markets require more stringent laws to prevent against technological manipulation by Russia, China, and other countries. Her remarks on Bitcoin were part of a longer portion in a November 24 interview with MSNBC TV news host Rachel Maddow on how certain countries use social media platforms. Clinton's warning included all kinds of technologies which she warned states and non-state actors could use to destabilize countries and the dollar status as the world's reserve currency. There's one other item on the horizon that people are just starting to pay attention to, she said, and that's the necessity to regulate the cryptocurrency market. Imagine combining social media with the ownership of particular Bitcoin networks to acquire even higher quantities of money, she continued. We're talking about powers like China, Russia, and others using technology to their advantage in a variety of ways. We're looking at non-state actors destabilizing the dollar as the reserve currency, either in collaboration with states or on their own. She was especially interested in how social media platforms, which have been used to sway elections through disinformation, may be linked with cryptocurrency markets to aid state and non-state actors in destabilizing other countries. Although this should not go into detail, such methods include manipulating markets, creating excitement, or even using social media troll farms to orchestrate a financial meltdown. In recent years, countries have used or publicly discussed utilizing cryptocurrencies to circumvent US economic sanctions. North Korea has utilized cryptocurrencies to fund its nuclear weapons program, for example. To evade discovery, the country has also deployed privacy coins and other techniques. Moreover, Japan's CBDC has been in the news recently. A group of 79 Japanese companies, including the country's top banks, have banded together to test and perhaps introduce a new digital version of the Japanese yen in fiscal 2022. Are you excited? Personally, I am. Let's find more about this digital yen. These private enterprises are establishing a platform known as digital currency JPY to assure that bank deposits will back the digital currency. Hence, the DCJPY will be a liability of each of the banks led by a startup called Decoret Cryptocurrency Exchange. Following testing trials in the coming months, the effort hopes to establish a yen-based digital money in fiscal 2022. The consortium's leader, Kazuhiro Tokita, chief executive of crypto exchange Decoret, spoke about the development during a news conference on Wednesday, November 24. The new digital currency known as DCJPY will be backed by bank deposits and rely on a single infrastructure to speed up massive cash transfers and settlements among participating enterprises, according to Tokita. The consortium has been meeting on a regular basis since last year to investigate ideas to create a new settlement platform for digital payments. Toshihide Endo, a former head of Japan's financial services agency, who is now a special advisor to Decoret, spoke at the conference as well, saying a digital currency system built on a bank deposit-backed common platform will fit the CBDC that might be developed and implemented in Japan. The consortium's endeavor is part of the corporate sector's assistance for the Bank of Japan's ongoing national CBDC experiment. If the BOJ issues a CBDC, government officials, including policymakers, have declared that they will cooperate closely with the business sector. So moving forward with our final segment for today evening, eToro, a social trading platform, has announced that it will delist Cardano and Tron for US consumers. In some tokens, affected users may be unable to establish new positions or earn staking incentives. Despite the delisting, the social trading platform stated that it remained dedicated to assisting the crypto sector. Well, after a long time I saw a delisting on such a big scale. I hope they bring up something for few of their disappointed customers. According to an eToro post, users in the United States will not be able to create new Cardano or Tron holdings after December 26, stating for such digital assets will terminate on December 31st. Furthermore, staking reward payouts will end on January 15, 2022, with the final incentive paid in US dollars rather than the relevant tokens. The company made it plain that they are prohibiting US consumers from creating new accounts. They're also not pressuring users to close open positions. Nonetheless, Cardano and Tron trade volume will decline over time as a result of this. The decision was made owing to considerations relating to the shifting regulatory environment, according to the business. It didn't go into any more detail about what this meant. These modifications are the result of business-related considerations in a developing regulatory environment. You will still have the option to close current roles as needed. eToro expressed a dissatisfaction with having to take this step. They are, however, still dedicated to actively supporting the whole crypto industry as a whole. So we would now wind up with the assessment for today evening and meet you all tomorrow with even more interesting stuff. Until then, you may consider joining our Telegram channel for free crypto signals. Visit our blog linked below for guides, reviews and tutorials, and subscribe to the channel and get daily updates about the crypto market. Lastly, with this little favor of CoinMonks, we hope you stay updated. Thanks for watching and have a nice day ahead.